Hello and greetings from Iceland. In this update, I'm going to talk about Grindavik, the people, how things look for the town, and do a little sightseeing around the town while I talk about how things look for our capital, since those are strange times here in Iceland. So this video is a bit longer than usual, and we start in Grindavik, where an eruption within the town looks more and more unlikely but still possible. However, the situation by the power station and the Blue Lagoon isn't looking as good. The amount of land uplift is 23 centimeters in 18 days, and in the recent days the land has risen by 1 centimeter a day. And we are about 3 centimeters short of reaching the position the land was in on October 25th. When the earthquake started that ended up with this new rift valley, and it is generally believed that this land uplift represents a countdown to the eruption that we've been waiting for over a month now. And if the magma influx continues at the same rate, we are talking about just a few days until the earthquakes will start again, telling us to get ready for just about anything after that. And the most likely place for an eruption is considered to be here, by the old Sundanjúkar craters. That is the official explanation today, but there are scientists out there that keep pointing at the so-called Illahraun lava field, just by the Blue Lagoon, or even the Eldvörp craters a bit further away. But let's focus at the official location now, and this is where lava barriers are under construction now. And below the barriers that will be placed here, we find the power station and the Blue Lagoon that just announced that it will remain closed for a while longer, or at least until December 7th, but I have the feeling that they won't open again this year. So things still remain hectic, but the town itself, Grindavik, is waking up little by little. A few companies started limited business operations again, like a machine shop and a fish processing company and one restaurant, but the town itself, it remains closed. You can't enter unless you have some business there, and it's closed to everyone during nights. So residents' expectations of moving home before Christmas are very slim now, and I don't think that anyone will move back permanently until this land uplift either stops for some time or ends up with an eruption. And if that would be the case, we would have to wait for the eruption to come to an end, which could be weeks or even months. However, the town's infrastructure like hot and cold water, electricity and sewage turned out to be in better shape than previously believed. Although it must be taken into account that the ground there is still recovering, still moving a bit, so pipelines and wires that are fine today might not be so tomorrow. Like sinkholes are discovered almost every day now, and the local search and rescue team is using them for practice, since sinkholes are quite new to us here in Iceland, so we won't know the total cost until perhaps next summer, since lots of those infrastructure issues won't be fixed while it's still freezing cold outside. And companies won't be allowed to open up for business unless the drains and water pipelines are in working order. But I say for myself that I would love to see some of the cafes open up and bring some life into town. See it open up again, even if it's just during daytime. But we are, however, still looking at a slow motion disaster. We already know that many of the local people won't return, and I can understand why. This was a major shock for them. But I can also understand the special breed of people in Grindavik who just want to get back to business. Grindavik is a good and strong community with valuable infrastructure like the fish processing facilities and a lot of know-how from this specialized workforce by one of the very few harbors by the south coast. And the harbor explains the location of the town between the volcanoes on the peninsula. I have been getting this question every now and then, why people live in this place, but it is of course the harbor. Like measurements indicate that the waves of the south coast of Iceland are amongst the highest and most energetic in the world, so they are a tourist sensation on its own, and they are also a tourist problem, like the sneaker waves, but like you see, not all listen. And most Icelandic towns grew from good harbor facilities. And the location of Grindavik is especially important when it comes to the fish industry. And the town has other benefits that I need to mention. Like I've been getting this question about trees on the peninsula every now and then. And we've actually been mocked for the lack of trees. But for no reason, because not only do we have trees there, it was the local people in Grindavik that planted this huge forest near the town. And it is so enormous that even a tourist got almost lost there a few years back. And we are very proud of our huge forests. And notice how it benefits from the shelter from this massive fault on the plate boundaries. And this is what you call adaptation to nature's faults. But back to the harbor, it wasn't always as good as it is now. Mother Nature didn't deliver it ready to use, and it took decades of work to make it into what it is today. And I'm leaving a link to a video that explains what I'm talking about when it comes to the value of good harbors by the South Coast. This is what our fishermen have to deal with. And the harbor master in Grindavik was actually telling us some good news, because the harbor is now 20 to 30 centimeters deeper than it was before November 10th, since the land under it subsided, but the piers sunk as well, of course, but that can be fixed. So the main thing is that it is easier and safer now to sail large ships into the port, and explains why the fishermen in this community want the restrictions to be lifted and get back to business. And the reason why people can't move back now has to do with how awful it would be to have to evacuate again if an eruption occurs north of town. So again, the word uncertainty is the best word to describe the situation here. And since I don't have any new drone footage from within the town, I had to think of ways to come up with some B-roll for this update. But I used the time in Reykjavik to wander around as close to Grindavik as I could go, legally, doing some calculations, like to see how far I could go on my drone, what the zoom lens would do for me, and overall just preparing for an eruption, calculating from where it would be best to cover it. So I was flying around a lot in this area by another volcano town called Vogar that we see here on a map. It's not within the restriction zone, and this is also where this extreme fissure swarm on the plate boundaries curves in a strange way, leaving us with some mighty strange features on the surface. And when I swap to drone view from this angle, I'm looking at the potential eruption site. This is a mountain Thorbjörn and Grindavik is behind it. And the 70mm lens on the drone is helping a lot in order to get the big picture. And I do have a super zoom camera as well, so I was also looking for locations for the tripod, and I found a few of them. So if and when something happens there, and if we will still have those restrictions that are way too stiff in my opinion, I will always be able to come up with something. And what the drone zoom lens is doing here is that it pulls the background closer to the foreground, so the image looks more compact, but it contains information that can be very valuable, like topographic information, or where will the lava flow. And what I'm also saying is that if we would get very lucky, and the seismic activity would move further to the northeast, the landscape around there could withstand a very large lava flow without causing any damage, or what we call a good tourist eruption. But this remains very open, and it is impossible to say now where it's going to come up. But nearby, we have a good testimony of the capacity of those volcanic systems there on the peninsula. Like, this is a sealed volcano that is surrounding the mountain Keilir that became the center of attention before the first three eruptions. And when we look at Keilir from this unusual angle with the zoom lens, we see how it is sticking up from this volcano shield that surrounds it and has covered it partially. And we were actually led to believe here in Iceland not so long ago that sealed volcanoes were this thing from the past, but that is not what the last three eruptions have been telling us, especially the one in 2021. So we are living in a new reality. And one of the things that makes Reykjanes such a fascinating subject for cameras is the fact that we could be seeing the beginning of a spectacular transformation of the youngest part of Iceland. Not just shield volcanoes created from eruptions that could go on for years, even decades. Recently, one of our experts was saying that the Mother Earth had, in the last 800 years, while the volcanoes on the peninsula were dormant, accumulated credit for 16 meters of displacement on the plate boundaries. And that's why we are entering this volcanic rifting chapter now, that we might enjoy for the next 200 or 300 years. And the November 10th event was the fastest rifting episode ever witnessed here in Iceland. And no one saw it coming, so it left the science community baffled. And in a way, we can say that all bets are off. We are in for a ride and we don't know where. And it was actually a surprise that the first eruptions on the peninsula turned out to be in this system. Many of us expected the huge Krýsuvík system to take off first. And it is still teasing us with earthquakes every day, especially by the lake Kleifarvatn. And given how Mother Nature came through the back door into the village Grindavik to everyone's surprise, I just have to ask about the future of Reykjavik and the metropolitan area in my upcoming videos. Since the Krýsuvík system stretches all the way into the city, like what we are looking at here is a swimming pool in the eastern part of Reykjavik. It was supposed to be here where the car park is, but when the construction started, it was discovered that the swimming pool would sit on a fissure from the Krýsuvík fissure swarm. So they moved the pool and made the crack in the ground disappear under the parking lot. And the sarcastic part of my brain is going to have a great time when I start to cover this better. Because we've been doing some strange things when it comes to new buildings. And I used this longest photo tour that I ever done in my life, 1 month in Reykjavik, to capture footage that will be turned into such stories about the future, since it is no secret that with 2 days geology knowledge, we would never have built the city where it is now. Maybe a few districts, but not more. So this is a huge story to work with. And I did actually start to work on it in 2021. And the working title was, Where Can We Move the Capital? So I have most of the footage already. And I am actually glad that I didn't finish it already, because this story is changing so fast now. And since the drone ban for Grindavik was extended into December, I decided to drive home to North Iceland and stay there for a few days at least. So I will do some of my updates from here for a while, but I'm ready to drive south in a hurry in case of an eruption. And like during previous eruptions, my channel took off, and I haven't even had time to say hello to my new subscribers, so I'm doing it now. And welcome to this little community around the channel, and the comment section is always a good source of inspiration for me, so I try to be as active as I can there. And even though the volcano coverage is the heart and soul of the channel, I'm also trying to make it into a comprehensive guide about Iceland for tourists, but I don't like tourist cliches, so I do things my way. So as for December, if I don't have to rush back to Reykjavik, in the next days, I have plenty of good videos to come, since I was very active filming this year, and I have way too much unpublished goodies. So I'm hoping to get some work done before the earthquake starts again, and the countdown timer for the next big event will be on, and it is just impossible to say how this will turn out, like fade out or turn into something different. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.